In this demo, we're going to take a look at auto failover groups in Azure SQL database. Now, we're back in my virtual machine, and once again, there are a few things going on. Ignore this right side for a moment, and we're going to talk about how I set up this auto failover group. Now, in this case, you can see I'm leveraging Azure PowerShell in a PowerShell notebook, and I went ahead and ran these cells just because it takes a few minutes. But what you can see is the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new logical server in a different region. So in this case, my primary is in East US, and I'm going to deploy what I'm calling a DR server in East US 2. So I'm just supplying basic information like the resource group name, the server name, the location for the new server, some credentials, as well as the password, which I'm passing securely. So basically, this creates a backup server in that failover region. And the next thing that I'm going to do is create a failover group between those two servers. So the new server that I created is completely empty at this point. Now, once I create the failover group or a connection between these two servers, I can then start to add multiple databases to the failover group, and it will manage the sync between them. In this case, I'm just adding one, that main AdventureWorks database, and we can add it basically by just using this command, add database to failover group. Now, once that completes, it's basically going to restore the database on the other server, the DR server, what I'm calling it in this case. And the final thing that you need to remember is that you're going to have access to that database in the event of an emergency. So you want to make sure, or for even Readscale, if you want your application or users to be able to access that server, you need to make sure you have the appropriate firewall rules or virtual network rules in place, as we've talked about in previous modules. So that's what we do there. And then finally, we can start to talk about what the heck is going on the right side. What we have is a simple Java application. And basically what it does is it tries to do an insert on the primary to the failover group. So what you'll notice is it's actually connected to the failover group connection string. So that's that read write listener or the read only listener that Bob talked about. And so we're going to try to do an insert on the primary, whatever it happens to be. And then we're going to try to read that insert from the secondary. So we just kind of updated this application, which is included in the sample code. And then I went ahead and ran the application. So it's running now. So now what we can do is we can check the status of our secondary server or our DR server in this case. So I'm just referencing the failover group and then the DR server. And the key part here is I want to grab the replication role. I can also check this in the Azure portal. If I go into my server under failover groups, I can select it. And even on the map, I can see what's in the primary. My East US is in primary and my secondary is in East US too. And here I'm getting those two read-write listener or read-only listener endpoints. So those don't change. Now, if I flip back to here, we can actually go ahead and use this switch statement to actually switch the primary and the secondary. So I'm going to kick this off, and what you're going to see is potentially for a few moments as this switch occurs, we're not going to be available on either of those servers. But very quickly, what you can see is we were able to get back to running and reading and inserting from both the readable and the writable. And now I can check the secondary, the replication role of the secondary server. And again, I'm seeing that as before it was the secondary, it's now the primary. And again, also in the portal, if I switch back, I can see that the primary is now that East US, my disaster recovery, what I call DR, and my secondary is in East US. So that's a pretty easy way to kind of see how easily you can set this up. You know, I'm sure it's very difficult to set this up in the on-premises world in your organization to kind of deploy an auto failover group to a whole other region. Now, the last thing we can do is fail back. So I'm going to basically use the switch command again and say I want the original server to be the primary now. So I'm going to kick this off and I want to show you something else. So first of all, what we'll see in the portal is that we'll see that this failover is happening, so we can track it here. Now, another thing you can do is leverage SSMS and leverage some DMVs. So right now I'm hitting the master in my logical server, and what I can see is a few things here. Let's see. What I can see here is that the replication state is catch up, which basically means we've been in sync. In that moment where we're down, this would show up as suspended. And the DMV that shows you that is geo replication links. Now, the other DMV you see below is DM operation status. And this one is actually going to show me that a failover occurred, and it'll show me what the state is, so it completed, and any errors or the start time and, you know, the last modified time, which is when it completed. And if we swap back to the notebook and our app, we can see, again, we momentarily became unavailable, but then we're able to start reading and writing again. And our status of our secondary has switched back to the secondaries. So this is awesome, but one other thing I wanted to throw in there is related to Readscale. So let's imagine this was a business critical database. So I basically have an availability group, and in my failover, auto failover group, I also have an availability group. So how many read replicas do I actually have? And there's an exercise you can go through, but basically I'll be able to access three readable secondaries in a way. The way I can do that is I can access the using the secondary. So these are those listeners I spoke about. So I can use the secondary and that'll be a readable. I can use the secondary, but since it's an business critical, it has an always on availability group. So I can also leverage the readable secondary that's associated with that. And then for my primary, I can also leverage the readable secondary. And the way you do that is basically by specifying the application intent as read only. And this is another T-SQL command you can run to kind of check, are you in a readable type of replica, or are you in the right one? So in this demo, you saw how easy it can be to set up auto failover groups, how a failover actually occurs, and that very short amount of downtime that you have. You also saw some various tools that you can use. You can use PowerShell, you can leverage the Azure portal, and you can monitor kind of the success and progress in SSMS. We also saw how you can get Readscale from these various auto failover groups, even if it was geo replication, especially due to the fact if you leverage business critical. See you in the next video.